A very good morning to all. Welcome to class 11th economics period. In the last class, we had already completed our chapter introduction to microeconomics of unit 1. The complete chapter is over, even with the assignment discussion and doubt class. So today we are starting a new chapter. We are starting unit number 3, because unit number 1 we have covered. Unit number 2, demand, is covered. Unit number 3, which is producers, behavior and supply, the complete unit, which is of 13 marks, producers, behavior and supply. In this unit, the very first chapter is production function. That we are starting today. That is production function. First of all, before I start the class by explaining you about the topic production function, let me first tell you the meaning of production, which you all must know already, that what is meant by production. Where we simply say that production means converting the raw material. It's a process, right? It's a process of converting the raw material into finished products. Which means if I'm saying that I have a raw material, for example, sugar cane, which is made by the primary industry, that sugar cane is needed to be converted into sugar, which would be a finished product used by many parties. So the process of converting the raw material into finished product is ultimately known as production function. All right. So when we say what is production function, production function is ultimately the relationship. Abhi hum log padhenge, we'll talk about the technical relationship also, but just I'm telling you the meaning of production, which is converting the raw material into finished products. Now the second question comes, what is production function? Ki production function hota kya hai? So what we call it? We call it the basic relationship between factors of production and the output which is produced is actually the production function. Two terms you all must know. The very first term, that is input, and the second term, which is output. What is input? For example, if you produce sugar, then definitely sugarcane is the input, right? If you produce sugar, sugarcane is the input. Not only the sugarcane, but also the labor which is working for converting the sugarcane into sugar. That is also an input. Wo bhi to ek input hai. So first of all, we must know that what are various inputs. See the diagram. That must be very much clear. See, first of all, we are talking about these inputs. That what are inputs? One by one will run. Okay. So first of all, we are talking about inputs. Now, if I talk about inputs, then I'll tell you that these are the inputs. These are the inputs. Ye sab aapke inputs hain. For example, you are going to produce anything. Definitely, you are going to use labor. You are going to use raw material, physical force, various tools like machineries also we are using, power and fuel, because to run that machinery, I require power and fuel also. I require labor. I require raw material, some physical force, some tools to operate that, some machinery, right? So various inputs we have to apply in the production. Various inputs we have to apply in the production, and then we get the output. And then we get the output. And you know, not only these, as capital is also the input. Yes, the capital is also the input. If I am applying some capital, that is also the input. So whatever amount I am investing, whatever amount I am providing to my production function as an input or as a raw material, as a compulsory process of production, those are called inputs. And what is output? Output is actually the final commodity. Final commodity means the final output, the final product which is ready, right? The final product which is ready. You must have seen, aap logon ne food factory show, I guess you all must have seen food factory show, jo discovery pe aata hai, food factory, right? The food factory show actually shows us the complete production function. Wo hame yahi dikhata hai, production function. It tells us that how a raw material or how an input can be converted into output. I was looking, ek bar I was just watching a show, that food factory, and they were just showing us the production of some chocolates. Now, if I talk about the chocolates, or if I talk about that how the chocolates are being produced, then definitely for the production of chocolates, they were showing various inputs to us that how they are actually going to convert the raw material into chocolates. They were using the labor. Of course, the labor was also assigned there, right? And they were using the labor, some raw material was there, physical force was, you know, being applied, tools and machineries, and some tools were there, which, and plants were there, plants and machineries and tools which they people were using to make the raw material into chocolates. And also because machinery was being used, power and fuel is also being used, because machinery of course would not run just by the air or water. Some power and fuel is required to, you know, run the machinery. So we can simply say that these all are the inputs, and when all the inputs are employed in the production process, when the inputs are applied in the production process, ye humne inputs ko lagaya production mein, and what do we get? We simply get the output, aur hame mil jata hai output. So I hope the production function is clear. So when we say what is production function, now coming back to the previous slide to just give you the meaning again of production function. See, so the basic relationship between factors of production, what are the factors of production? Now there are four factors of production, jo four categories of factors of production: land, labor, capital and entrepreneur. So four factors of production are there. So the basic relationship between factor of production and factors of production and output is ultimately referred to as the production function. Now the firm's production function for a particular good Q, यहाँ पे हम बात करते हैं जरा प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन की, दैट इफ वी वांट टू राइट द टेक्निकल प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू राइट इट एज टेक्निकली. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दैट, कि हम लोग इसको टेक्निकली कैसे लिखते हैं. सो सपोज प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन इज डिफाइंड एज बाय क्यू, इन विच वी से क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू, क्यू मीन्स इट शोज द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ द गुड that can be produced, all right, quantity. So quantity is equals to function of all inputs. Quantity is equals to function of all inputs, combining all labor, combining labor and even combining capital, which is denoted by K, right? Even we can include all the factors inputs which are being applied. Hum isme sare factor inputs bhi apply kar sakte hain, right? So this is basically the production function. Isko hum bolte hain production function. So production function is the technical or functional relationship between physical inputs and physical outputs. Now what are the physical inputs? See, the labor, the capital which I have mentioned, these are the physical inputs, right? And what are the physical output? Physical output is this quantity. Physical output, if I talk about the physical output, this physical output is this quantity, and this LK, labor capital, this, you know, is this is the physical input. So we can simply say that production function refers to the functional or technical relationship between physical inputs and physical output. All right, fine. So जिसके अंदर हमने फिर ये देखा, and where we simply know that whenever in the production process we are applying all inputs like power and fuel, like labor, like raw material, physical force, some tools, some plants and machineries, in the production process simply we get the output, and output is ultimately the final commodities. Output is ultimately the final commodities. All right, so simple hai, what is production function? Production function is the relationship between physical inputs and physical output. Ki physical input apply karke kitna physical output generate hua, that is known as the production function. I hope this is clear till now. So moving to the further slide, next slide. Important facts about production function. So important facts, some facts about production function. Now what are these facts? Very first, if we see, a production function is expressed with reference to a particular period of time. Of course, it is based on a period of time. For example, if I am making chocolates or if I am making sugar, then my one of my production function would refers to convert the sugarcane into sugar. Jitna sugarcane maine liya from farmer, aur utna sugarcane se मैं जो शुगर बना रहा हूँ, जितने टाइम पीरियड में वो प्रोसेस स्पेसिफाइड हो जाएगा, वो उसकी बात यहाँ पर हो रही है. दैट अ प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन इज बेसिकली एक्सप्रेस विद रेफरेंस टू अ पर्टिकुलर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. पीरियड ऑफ टाइम के लिए होता है प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन, वन मंथ, टू मंथ, थ्री मंथ, वन वीक, टू वीक. एंड इट एक्सप्रेसेस विच रिलेशन? इट एक्सप्रेसेस द फिजिकल रिलेशन और इवन द फंक्शनल रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन बोथ इनपुट्स एंड आउटपुट्स. ऑल राइट, so basically the physical relationship is being expressed that how many inputs I have applied, how many inputs I have applied during the process of production, and what amount of output I am generating from that. This is being told by the production function, that what amount I have applied as an input and what I am getting as an output. All right, so let's see the third one. Production function describes a purely technological relationship, because what can be produced from a given amount of input depend on the state of technology. That's why I said that it is related to, or it is called as technical or functional relationship also, because what will be produced, that is dependent on what kind of technology I am having. Right, if I talk about Canada, you can see in the Canada, if you see the videos of food factory, basically food factory videos comes from Canada, they have a big plants and machineries in their factories, you know, a big plants and machineries, huge plant and machineries which they people are using for their production process. So if they are getting a very good amount of output, if they are getting a very you know, best amount of output, then it is so because they have a very good state of technology also. Because if they don't have good state of technology, if they don't have good state of technology, then definitely it's a thing that they would not be able to perform it better. So if they are able to do so, that means they are having a good amount of technology also. So moving further, types of production function. There are two types of production functions, short run production function and long run production function. But before this, I would like to tell you one other thing. I would like to tell you about two types of factors first. We have fixed factors and variable factors. First of all, you must know this. Then would be able to learn what is short run and long run. You know, in the production, we use two factors. One is the fixed factor, other is the variable factor. You have a factory. What do you think? Factory is a fixed factor or factory is a variable factor? If you have a factory, then factory would be fixed factor or variable factor, which means can you change the factory frequently? I think I can't change the factory frequently, because my factory is my setup of the production.
And if it is my setup of the production, if it is my setup of the production, where I have installed plant and machinery, where I have installed other tools which are required for the due course of production, I am not going to change it at all. Right? I am not going to change it. Which means factory is the fixed factor. Fixed factor means which you are not going to change very frequently. At least in short run, you are not going to change fixed factor. For example, machine. A hospital buys ECG machine or X-ray machine that cost it almost lakhs, right? Do you think that the hospital is going to change that machine very frequently?
My answer would be no. That is not, it is not going to change the factory very frequently.
Reason? Because is not going to change that machinery, that machine, ECG or X-ray machine very frequently. Because usko wo bahut mehengi cost padi hai. And of course, it is not going to change it at all. So fixed factors are basically those factors. Of course, these are used in production process, no doubt. But these do not change with the change in the volume of output. Or these do not change with the change in period of time, at least in short run. These do not change at all. Fixed factors. Now talk about variable factors. Variable factors, for example, which we can change. For example, raw material, labor, that can be changed over a period of time. Short run mein ho sakta change. Short run mein bhi ho sakta, long run mein bhi change ho sakta. Right? It can be changed over a period of time. So if we define fixed factors and variable factors, so let us define with the base of output. आपके पास एक मशीनरी है, आप चाहे रोज का सपोज 10 यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस करो, रोज की 20 यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस करो, 50 यूनिट्स प्रोड्यूस करो, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज द मशीनरी वेरी सून इन द शॉर्ट रन, विच मीन्स मशीनरी इज द फिक्स फैक्टर. बट व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट द वेरिएबल फैक्टर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेबर, बिकॉज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रोड्यूस मोर देन डेफिनेटली यू नीड टू हैव मोर लेबर. And if you are producing less, definitely you will reduce the labor. Lockdown. Lockdown period is going on, right? People have factories, but if their factories are shut down during the lockdown, definitely they are not going to change the machineries because machineries are being installed in the factory. But don't you think that they people are going to change the labor? They people are going to fire the labor because production is not going on. When production is not going on, people are not working, the factory is not able to generate the income, then definitely factory is not going to give any, the factory is not going to give any amount of salary to labor. And so as the factory is going to reduce the labor, right? So when we define the fixed factor, we simply say that fixed factors are those factors which does not change, which does not change with the level of, basically which does not change over a period of time. It doesn't change over a period of time. But when we talk about the variable factors are those factors which changes even in short run or in long run. जिसको आप चेंज इजिली कर सकते हो उसको बोलते हैं हम लोग वेरिएबल फैक्टर्स. ऑल राइट, सो नाउ लेट अस डिफाइन शॉर्ट रन एंड लॉन्ग रन. सी, शॉर्ट रन अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वेयर प्लांट साइज इज फिक्स्ड, लेबर इज वेरिएबल. कांट वी से अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वेयर फिक्स्ड factors are fixed in nature and variable factor changes, that is short run. Which means in the short run, in the short period of time, you are not going to change the fixed factors, but you are going to change the variable factors. That's why we simply say Short run is that period of time in which plant size is fixed, means fixed factor remains fixed and variable factor changes. Same way, if I talk about long run, jo niche wala, that is long run. If I talk about long run is that period of time where any factor can be changed. All factor becomes variable. You can change the machinery also in the long run. And even you can change the, of course, raw material and labor, we can easily change it. So that is known as long run. All right. I hope the topic which we have covered till now is clear. First of all, what is production function? Production function in which we are explaining about the production definition. Then we are explaining, even we can use this diagram in exam also, where we can explain that the physical relationship between the inputs and outputs is the production function, because it helps us in making or in it helps us in converting the inputs into outputs. So that is the production function. Then if we talk about the next slide, then we can say, I told you important facts about production function. Then types of production function, we have short run and long run production function, short run and long run, then fixed factors and variable factors. I hope this is clear to everybody, right? Okay.